I will show you how to make two-dimensional logos three-dimensional and how you show them in three-dimensional with After Effects. First of all, we define a logo for ourselves and we want to show this logo in three dimensions. So you have to make sure that this logo is a vector. Save it as an Adobe Illustrator file. This is how I name it and click on the Save button. In the window that comes afterwards, we can click on the OK button. Now let's go back to After Effects and right-click on the Project panel. Select Import and File. The Import option allows us to import any file from our computer into After Effects. So I'm going to select the Illustrator file that we just saved and then I will change the Footage option at the bottom to Composition. I'm changing it to Retain Layer Sizes, then click on the Import button. When I double-click on the logo file, we will see that it comes here as a composition. This is the logo we added and the background is currently black by default. We can change it to any color. For this, we need to create a new solid layer. I right-click on an empty area of the timeline and select New Solid. Here, we assign any color to the field called Color. We can change this color in the future. I click OK and click OK again to move the layer under the logo. So, our logo is here. It is also possible to change the color of the logo. I go to the Effects panel. If you don't see this Effects panel, make sure that the Effects Presets option under Window is checked. Then, we type Tint here. When we drag the tint effect onto this logo, we can change the color of the logo with these options. For example, let's make it a light blue tone. Now that we have prepared our logo and composition, we can turn it into a three-dimensional view. For this, I right-click on the logo and select Create Shapes from Vector Layer. It will create a new layer. We can delete the original layer. Now, in order to convert this object to 3D, we first need to activate the three-dimensional feature of this object. For this, we need to select the icon under the three-dimensional icon on the timeline. We show that this object can be used in three dimensions. So, when we click on the layer, as you can see, there will be coordinates on the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, where we can move this object. Now, at the bottom right of the scene, you will see a text here. How can I show this text? It has disappeared. If I zoom in a little bit more, if I make adjustments with these windows a little bit, I can see that this text appears. I click on it and I change the option here from Classic 3D to Cinema 4D, which can be a little bit tiring on your computer. Now let's open the properties of the layer again in the timeline section and then open the geometry options. And we need to give this logo some depth so that we can get the three-dimensional feel. So I'm going to change the depth option and set it to 60 at the beginning and then we need to put a camera in the scene. For this, we choose Layer, New, Camera. After that, we don't need to touch any settings. I click OK and then in the toolbox there, you will see the camera movement tool. By selecting this tool, we change the angle of the camera by dragging on the scene and we will get that three-dimensional feeling. Right now, it doesn't have that three-dimensional feel, nor is our color what we specified. Because when we changed this option to a vector layer, it used its default color. Now let's go to Contents to change the color of this object on the scene. You will probably see the word Group. Let's open this and you will see the fill value. The gray part inside this fill value is the color of our main object. We can change this again. As you can see, we can change the color we want. We can leave this like this to start with. And because we have changed the main object three-dimensionally, it's a little bit higher. And we can change the angle of that with the pan tool here. So, these icons, the one on the left is rotate the camera, the one on the right is pan, and you will see another icon just to the right of it. And we use this tool to zoom in order for us to perceive an object as three-dimensional, there needs to be light in the scene, so that the shadows and the brightness add a sense of three dimensions to that object. Let's create our light from the point where we just created the camera. I choose Layer, New, Light. And here we have Spotlight selected. We can leave other settings this way. I click on the OK button. Look, when I click on the OK button, the places where the light hits are bright and the places where the light doesn't hit are in the shadow. So, they look darker than the brightness part. By changing the angle of this light, we can make these dark black areas a bit more visible. I select Spotlight and press the letter P on the keyboard. P for position. And let's play a little bit with the position of the light. This is how I move the light to a point where the dark areas are as little visible as possible. Now let's select our main image again. So let's select the logo here on the timeline and I press the letter R on the keyboard. When I press the letter R, the rotation properties will open. We can make it look three-dimensional by giving an animation like this. Let's do it now. Here I click on the icon on the left of Y. We have given a keyframe to the first frame of the timeline and I'm going to take a little bit further. I can increase it. I rotate it like this and when I look at it like this, we have given the logo a three-dimensional effect. If you want, you can change the color of the object again from the place we just mentioned. I'm going to go to the fill value and I'm going to change the color here to another color. I will put a red tint saying the heart will be red. I go to the fill value and I change the color here to another color. We can increase the brightness of this light a little bit. For this, I go to the settings of the spotlight and I increase the intensity a little bit. We can make it 150. We create a little bit brighter, a little bit stronger light. Again, this is how we make it three-dimensional. Yes, it looks visually simple, but in this video, I showed you how standard logos that we created with Adobe Illustrator can look three-dimensional in After Effects. You can develop this according to your own technique. That's it for this video. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.